back. I'm thankful for the part that we all in this week. Two of them here, Dr. Schuler yesterday, the others, that's my niece, Mary Lynn. I was away from you all last week. I was with my kids on their spring break, so it's good to be back with you during this whole week. The weather kind of resembles what were the extremes of what this week is. Holy Week going through the passion of Maundy Thursday, Commandment Thursday. This is my commandment that you love one another. Jesus washing the disciples' feet. The Last Supper Thursday evening, Good Friday, and all the events that take place then. And then the huge transition, just like our weather, snow, and then Sunday it's been 70 degrees and sunny. Easter resurrection weather. I'm coming for Resurrection Sunday. Today, however, we have a Testimony Tuesday. Many of you know quite well Dr. Burkart. Is going to share a couple of his faith mentors, things growing up. But before we do, we're going to sing a song of Dr. Burkart's. This is a foretaste of the feast to come. Dr. Burkart has done many, many signings over the years for Concordia, for our district, for our church body. And this is a song for next year's LEA week.
No, National Lutheran Schools Week.
National Lutheran Schools Week. For next year.
For the 2018.
So it's a little chilly in here. Let's warm up by welcoming one another. Stand. Welcome one another. If you want to bring a little sick person.
Thank you.
You can take that off. Nothing like catching somebody on the street and just snack.
A few things to share. Questions for Dr. Burkart on this testimony Tuesday, but I want to start out with a thank you. I first met Dr. Jeffrey Burkart probably 20 years ago, a little more. Dr. Burkart was doing, the theater pieces you wrote at the theater.
Oh, yeah. Gospel Time in Gospel.
Gospel Time in Gospel. Right. Anybody remember Gospel Time in Gospel? A huge ambassador for Gordy St. Paul. I grew up to it for many years. But you asked my wife Amy to play violin and me to play bass. Got to know each other, and now we're married. So thank you.
Just what I do.
In addition, in addition to that, however, at that time in my life, I was very torn whether to do music or pursue music, attempt music as a profession, or to go into the ministry. And there were two people on campus at that time, yourself and Pastor Jerry Cole, who, as a professor, were extremely busy and talented. Pastor Coleman, as a pastor, is extremely talented, sharing his musical gifts that way. So taught me a little bit about how to use music ministry as a professor and Pastor Coleman as a pastor. So thank you, Dr. Burkart, for both of those things very much.
Thank you.
A big mentor for me. If you will, Dr. Burkart is notoriously not short on words, so we'll try to keep this for our time. But in a nutshell, Your life story in a nutshell. You're a Chicago guy. So.
I was born. grew up in Chicago. Very quickly, I grew up with an extended family. My mom, my dad, and my father is my grandfather, my grandmother. My mother's parents died when she was 11, so she was orphaned. So I didn't know my grandparents on my mother's side. From Yugoslavia, actually Slovenia, because at that time brought up a Yugoslavian thing. And he was a coal miner, and he came over. They both got tuberculosis within 6 months of each other. And my mother and father were childhood sweethearts, if you will. Not really, but they knew each other from kindergarten all the way through high school. And my dad went to while he's in Sunday school. And she said, well, yes. And this is how it works. 6 weeks later, she was baptized as an adult. And I ended up going to move to school. I ended up moving to school. My whole life, I'm still in one. I can't believe it. With a few sojourns into the secular world at the University of Nebraska, Lincoln, and the experiences at the University of Minnesota. So, that's enough.
We're going to
Chicago. And pretty much time, we're going to Teachers College. Go Cougars. In Chicago, we're forced on the Chicago, the University of Chicago.
So you shared a couple of faith mentors growing up. How about when you got here to be pretty small?
I have to tell you one more. I know the time is short. When you just passed away at 86 years of age, my second grade teacher, well, this day really was fantastic. She taught me about the gospel. When all around me was preaching along, she taught me about the gospel. But there was a man in second grade, his name was Rudolph W. Heinz. He passed away just a few weeks ago. I talked to his wife, Mildred, on the phone on Monday. I've known him since second grade, so it's over 60 years. Relationship. He was my second grade teacher, my fifth and sixth grade teacher, and then my college history teacher. He went over to England and taught at Oak Hill College. One of you may have remembered the program at Oak Hill. His books, by the way, were published by Northwestern Oxford University Press, one of the great scholars of the English Tudor kings and all that. Along with about a dozen other teachers I can talk about, but since he just passed away, in his memory, I'll tell you, he was so influential in my life throughout my grade school life and then into college because he had an unswerving and lovely gospel-oriented disposition. Always positive, always encouraging. If there's one teacher that I can tell you about, he was the most influential.
I'll give you 12 seconds.
Okay, I'm all right. It just helped to lose some of them, but it's okay. Go ahead. Maybe like that. There you go. As the older wife, believe me, these things show a little bit differently than they do when they're younger. Yeah.
And you were younger at one time.
Yeah. Oh, yes.
When I came here to embrace St. Paul,
yeah. Also,
students imagine Professor Lewis or Professor Goshman, 20, 30, 40 years down the road, sitting right here. So when you first came here, Dr. Burkart,
30 years old.
Who are faith mentors that kind of that you looked up to when you first came here?
I must tell you, there are so many. There's Lohmann Gehringmeier. I could talk about this for an hour. Lohmann Gehringmeier, Steve Bowman, my friend Tyler Trapp, my next door neighbor, Bob Cole, and Pauline. They all have lives. It just goes on and on. Because now, if I don't say them all, then I'm not going to make a church. There have been so many people here who you constantly can discuss great things with, that you can share things with. They are kind of, in my case, they were colleagues. In your case, they're teachers. If one thing that I wish students were doing more, I don't know, it just may age is taking away from them, not teaching in the same way I did 70 years ago. But go into your path and talk with them, not necessarily you're great. Talk about that, share your ideas, bring to your professors and whatever you're interested in discipline. They will, they are eager to talk to you, believe it or not. Occasionally, you might think someone's a little bit shy about that, but 99% of the time, they'll talk to you. And my colleagues here have been like that. They're just so many. My former student, the friend, Paul Palmer. I mean, that just can go on. Sharon, sincere Sharon, has been here as long as I have, I guess. But you were here, and she was a graduate here, so she gets more perks there, as it were. But you want to talk to someone, talk to Sharon, you want to talk about a person who's on the vice-station. They're all over. And they have a tremendous effect on me. They made me grow into a more Christian human being.
Last question. Mm-hmm. You've been married to converted St. Paul for a long time. Yeah. You've seen many variations and ebbs and flows in the ministry. What are your hopes and dreams going forward for converted St. Paul?
Well, there's so many things that have changed over the years. Some for the better, some maybe not so much. But like Frank Sinatra said in the song, the great side had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I would hope that, and we've talked about this before, Tom, that this place is an incubator of the Christian life, and that every student here can come into contact with people who will witness, not necessarily by the words, Francis said, always preach the gospel when necessary, use words, but that our lives will be one filled with the love of Christ to everybody who comes in contact with. Because there's no more holy object that you can stand before than another person, and to recognize that person as God's holy creation. And no matter where they are, what their stage of life, no matter what particular denomination or religion they belong to, no matter what their intellectual capacity or their talent, that they are a sacred object, and that you view them as that, and that through your living out the Christian life, being kind, extraordinarily kind. In Cinderella, I've never seen Cinderella. Is it known? Have courage and be kind, the mother says to Cinderella. How many of you have seen the new one? Oh, if you haven't seen it, go right there. 480. Have courage and be kind. I put up a sign on my door by Australian author of the 19th century, Adam Sidney. It says, life is full of thought and bubble. Two things stand like stone. Kindness in another's trouble. Courage in your own. Adam Sidney Gordon. Kindness and courage. Be kind because God says to be kind. And then also in your own life, take courage in the fact that your Savior has taken it all on himself, and you can go forward because he's given you the ability in your baptism to respond to the needs of those people around you in whatever your vocation is. But I guess that's fine.
Thank you, Dr. Burkart. Let's close with a word of prayer. Lord, we give you thanks for the gift of this day and ask your blessings as we are sent. May your kingdom come, your will be done. We pray, Lord Jesus, for Chris Tucson to her this week. We ask your blessings on those Christians in Egypt recovering from the attacks. We ask your blessings on the shooting at the school in California. Be with the administration, the local police, those in the area and in relationship who would seek to help and to heal. I thank you, Lord God, for Dr. Jeffrey Burkart and the seed that planted, washed him in the waters of baptism and have used him in a powerful way in his ministry and teaching and his music. We thank you for his presence here at Concordia St. Paul and ask your blessings on his continued ministry. Send us this day, Lord, to live with kindness and to live with courage, to live forgiven. All this we pray in your holy name. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Go in peace and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.